argues that we are living in a world where the economic, political, religious, historical powers are less free to operate in a condition by mass media and social media as never before. That's true, that's true. I believe that if we see our reality, we see that there is no big power like before, no? Nor the president, American president, neither other, they can do what they want completely with all the authority. The authority is questioned. The authority has to be balanced by many powers. The question is, does less power mean a positive evolution of liberal democracy, or it's a symptom of terminal decay? Very simple question. Maybe two possibilities. First possibility, more check and balances means that democracy, it is improving. Less power one means that many people can have more power. Everybody can negotiate, can decide, you know. This may be one possibility. But the second possibility is that less power is the same situation that we saw in the past history, during the fall of civilization, fall of empires, before revolutions that changed completely the world. So which one of these two possibilities is the true one? Dear colleagues, brothers and sisters, because we are brothers, because this is just not a problem of to be different. We are brothers and sisters. We are the same generation with this problem. Our generation has to fix the problem. We are the sailors on this ship of this civilization. I'm going to refer to speak only about the liberal Western democracy, not about all the world. So, two possibilities. First possibility, first answer, it is a positive effect. End of power may mean more check and balances fundamental to democracy. Less representation may mean more participation. Okay? First possibility. Is it true? We have an example, for example. An example of an Italian movement, not because I'm Italian. Here we are three Italians, they are here. I would like to greet Italians here. Hello, Italians. But I would say the Movement 5 Star is a political party that in the last election, it received 8,070,000 of voters. Can you imagine 8 million of people? And this is the most important party, they didn't want to use no newspaper, no television, nothing, only internet. Can you imagine a party that became the most important without newspaper, without the media? It happened. Of course. The movement Five Stars denies representative democracy. What is representative democracy? That the citizen vote someone on the top represent them. But the movement Five Stars say, it is the past. Because now we do not need representation. We are free, each one can say, can have his opinion using internet without needing to use the newspaper, the journalist, report. They are going to interpret the situation. And they foster, and the movement fosters, and they foster direct democracy. It means nobody speaks for others. One is worth one. Direct democracy, it is equal to e-democracy. E-democracy, electronic democracy. No, email. But, for example, this is the graph of the network of the Facebook account of Riello Institute. If you can say, this is a graph, you can see that even in a network, not all the nodes are connected with the same number of connection with others. Some node has more connection. It means that even inside the network, there are a difference of a ranking difference. There are more important nodes and less important nodes, because if there are nodes more connected than other, they have more influence than the other. It means that even inside the network, even inside in a non-representative democracy, there are difference of ranking, hierarchy different. First point. But now, imagine now to speak about the second possibility. I have to go very fast because each of these slides we can remain hours. Imagine the second, the negative outcome. What is the decay of power? What if this decay of power is the expression of a sickness of liberal democracy? The moment of a transition to a new different social structure. The first sign of the fall of a civilization. Maybe. You know, because if it is vanishing the power, maybe there's something we are lacking. We mean that people, they do not identify themselves with power. And when human beings, they do not identify with the government, it is the pre-revolution moment, usually in the history. So power becomes fragile in pre-revolution times. Thereafter, revolution start up, new strong power is created, and a new order substitute the previous one. Example. First example, fall of Roman Empire. You can see here a picture, no? A painting of the typical idea that we have about the Roman Empire. By the way, I am Roman, but now I'm not an emperor. Now, I would like to stress this to highlight, because my faith, maybe that my ancestor, some Nero or Julius Caesar, maybe, who knows? We do not know, but anyway, this is a Roman emperor. And the Roman emperor, you see, the flatterers around him, no? Everybody, no? Everybody is waiting for the order of the emperor. It looks that the emperor has a big power, strong power, infinite power. There is no decay of power. Moshe Naindi says that now we have the decay of power. That time, no decay of power. The emperor, strong emperor. Roman Emperor Constantius II is a typical example of a big power with no limits. Nevertheless, the force, according to Ammianus, tell us that before this is a mistake in the slide, that the emperor had to was doing a war against Alemannia. Alemannia is a people in the north of Europe. And he was winning the battle, but at the end he thought that it was better for Romans to do a treaty of peace. Emperor, big power, but he had to ask the approval of the army. The emperor, the big emperor, had to ask, using some statement like this, no? Speaking to the soldiers. And I believe that there are many reasons why, if I have your approval, if I, the emperor, have your approval, the peace should be granted. Can you imagine, if I have your approval? This is decay of power. Emperor had to ask the approval of the soldiers. It means that his power is not so strong. But why at that moment? 50 years later, the sack, the Goths, the barbarians, sack a room with his army, with their army, and began the fall of Roman Empire. Rome, the city that they said that it was impossible to destroy Rome was sacked. Second example, France, 1787. King Louis, still the expression of absolute power. By the way, the expression absolute power, l'état c'est moi, it is of the French kings. At that time, King Louis, he was still the expression of absolute power on the monarchy in France. He summoned a representation of notables to assure support for the new tax reform. New tax reform. Have you ever heard about taxes here in the United States? Is there any problem like that?
No.
Do you know why King Louis was to do a tax reform? Because he had a huge, incredible national debt. Have you ever heard about this topic here? About the American debt, about Italian debt? The same situation. He summoned, You can see in this picture, everybody's around the king. The king is in the middle. The king, everybody, it looks that he has a complete, absolute power. Complete, absolute power. But a huge debt, tax reform. Can you imagine that this, after 3 months of discussion, the assembly floundered? It was a shipwreck of the monarchy. His minister of finance dismissed it, was exiled, and the elite close to the king, the aristocratic elite, denied the project. So his power, the king's power, was an end of the power. Do you know what happened? Five years later, the head of the king, the king's head, fell down into the basket that was shown to thousands of people gathered to see the execution at Place de la Concorde. Because in 5 years started the French Revolution, the people in the street, and the decay of power, the vanishing of power, was just an overture, a prelude to something that was too good to happen. Very in condition, huge debt, tax reform, and people that they are far from the power. The power believes to be strong, but it's not strong. By the way, beware, please. Is anybody sleeping now? Please wake up. Wake up, please. By the way.